This week, China's gasoline and gas oil exports are likely to remain muted and caught a shortage. Market eyes Indian coal import tender from a major state-owned firm, and Asia-Pacific LNG market likely to see rise in spot trading activity after holidays. But first, Asian refiners are expected to sharply raise their term Middle Eastern crude intake, following the latest OPEC Plus decision to accelerate production hikes through the summer. The refiners continue to maximize operating rates to fully capture lucrative middle distillate cracks, especially for diesel and jet fuel. Chinese end users and some Indian refiners are widely expected to continue absorbing Russian crude. At the same time, refiners in Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, and Thailand would be able to take a decent share of the incremental OPEC supply, especially from Saudi Arabia and the UAE, over the coming trading cycles. Meanwhile, China's gasoline and gas oil exports are likely to remain muted throughout the week and the rest of the month. Beijing is hesitant to release oil products export quotas in large quantities because of its strong focus on domestic energy security. Market participants had expected Beijing to hand out about 26 million barrels of supplementary quotas for gasoline, gas oil, and jet fuel before end May. However, there's still no official confirmation on the new export quota allocation, further raising the case for low-run middle distillate exports. That brings us to our social media question for the week. Will higher output by OPEC Plus help tame rising crude oil prices in Asia? Share your thoughts on Twitter and LinkedIn. Moving on to metals. Demand from the manufacturing sector is expected to increase after COVID-19 lockdowns were lifted in Shanghai last week. The recovery, however, will be hampered by supply chain and longer than expected delivery schedules. Iron ore futures on the Darling Commodity Exchange hit a six-week high before the long weekend holiday in China that began June 3 amid government measures to support the ailing economy. A recovery in Chinese demand could have a positive impact on steel product prices in the second half of 2022. In coal, market expects India's state-owned Coal India to issue a tender this week to import coal from other origins to avoid a shortage later this year. India's coal procurement is expected to be both for the spot market and spread out over the next few months to increase stockpiles at power plants. In China, the reopening of Shanghai is expected to boost power demand, and consequently, the demand for seaborne coal from Indonesia is expected to rise. Finally, in LNG, the Asia-Pacific LNG market could see a pickup in spot trading activity this week, as Chinese and Japanese firms return from their week-long holidays. Market participants will be closely watching the impact of EU's gradual ban on Russian oil amid expectations of restocking demand improving closer to the peak summer demand season. Despite limited downstream demand from North Asian end users, market fundamentals have become more balanced due to interest for prompt deliveries in South Asia and Southeast Asia. Thank you for kicking off your Monday with us. Have a great week ahead.